This is Radio Nepal. I'm Dela Prasai with the news, the headlines first. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal, Prachanda addresses plenary session on food systems transformation on sidelines of UN Food System Summit in Italy. Prime Minister Dahal stresses the need for fighting battle against hunger and food insecurity. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda says that his government initiates a campaign to promote social justice and good governance. Dengue infection on the rise in the country. Over 4,000 people across the country infected with dengue fever. And China replaces Foreign Minister Qin Gang with Wang Yi. Now the news in detail. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda says that his government has initiated a campaign to promote social justice, good governance and national development. Prime Minister Dahal said this during the program organized by the non-resident Nepali Association in Italy. The Prime Minister also highlighted the government's commitment to tackle corruption. Prime Minister Dahal further added that the government has prioritized the establishment of an orderly society and raised the living standards of citizens across the nation. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda has stressed the need for fighting the battle against hunger and food insecurity more resolutely. In his keynote address to the plenary session on food systems transformation in practice on the sidelines of the UN Food System Summit in Rome of Italy on Tuesday, the Prime Minister called for more equitable, resilient and sustainable food systems to address multiple challenges the society was facing. Presenting the assessment to the progress made so far since the Food System Summit in 2021, Prime Minister Dahal said affording healthy diet was difficult for almost 3 billion people in 2020. He added that the COVID-19 pandemic worsened the scenario, while the climate crisis and conflicts on different parts further worsened the situation. As he approached the session, modern food systems fall short in providing a pathway for a sustainable future. Prime Minister Dahal argued that the modern food systems had worsened climate change by contributing to greenhouse gas emissions and loss of indigenous practices. The Prime Minister further stated that the government of Nepal was fully committed to implementing the Right to Food and Food Sovereignty Act 2018 for sustainable food systems in the country. He said Nepal adheres to the Act and aims to strengthen its efforts in achieving a more equitable and resilient food systems that ensures the right to food for all citizens. The Prime Minister added that Nepal has a least developed country. Nepal, as a least developed country rather, was marked by additional challenges including adequate storage, cold chains, high production costs, weak market linkages and uneven distribution system in its efforts for transformation of food systems. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachanda and Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina held talks on matters of bilateral interest and concern on the sidelines of United Nations Food System Summit in Rome on Monday. Prime Minister's press coordinator Surya Kiran Sharma said they held significant talks regarding enhancing collaboration in agriculture and hydropower sectors between Nepal and Bangladesh. Prime Minister Dahal and his Bangladeshi counterpart Hasina also discussed various topics related to regional cooperation and partnership. Meanwhile, Prime Minister Dahal and Director General of Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, FAO, Qiu Dongqiu, held a meeting in Rome on Tuesday. According to Prime Minister Dahal's secretary, during the meeting held at FAO headquarters, they discussed various issues related to enhancement of agricultural practices, food insecurity and sustainable development. Likewise, Prime Minister Dahal and President of International Fund for Agriculture Development, IFAD, Alvaro Lario, have held a meeting. During the meeting, they reviewed the relations between Nepal and IFAD and different projects run by IFAD in Nepal. Over 4,000 people across the country have been diagnosed with dengue fever. Director at Epidemiology and Disease Control Division Rudra Prasad Marasini has said that dengue infection is on the rise due to continuous rain and poor hygiene. He further said that there are 4,289 dengue patients across the country at present. The security experts have stressed on developing a common understanding among the political leadership on the issues of national security and foreign policy. In yesterday's meeting of the National Concern and Coordination Committee of the National Assembly, the security experts suggested considering internal and external challenges while formulating national security policy. They also underscored the need for inter-agency coordination while dealing with national security and foreign policies. Deputy Prime Minister and Home Minister Narayan Gajeshwar has pledged to bring all individuals found involved in crime to justice. During a press conference organized by the Press Center Nepal in Gorkha yesterday, the Home Minister said the police were acting seriously to enhance security measures and curb the crime. He claimed that the police were meticulously investigating the latest case of gold smuggling. Minister for Federal Affairs and General Administration Aman Lal Modi says the government is committed to ensuring a smooth supply of seeds and fertilizer to farmers. While inaugurating a bridge over the Lohanto River in Morang yesterday, the minister said the government had prioritized the farmers' needs for seeds and fertilizer and was working accordingly. You're listening to Radio Nepal 8M English News Bulletin. We continue with the international updates now. China has removed Qin Gang as foreign minister less than 7 months after he was appointed to the post. According to the Chinese news agency Xinhua, the role will be taken up by the Communist Party's foreign affairs chief Wang Yi, who was previously foreign minister. The 57-year-old's last known public engagements were on the 25th of June. China's top legislature voted to appoint Wang Yi as the foreign minister. Three people became the first known fatalities in Tuesday wildfires that have been raging on Greek islands for the week, and Prime Minister Kyriakos Mitsotakis warned of tough days ahead as the blazes destroyed homes and forced tourist evacuations. Two pilots were killed when their Candair CL-215 plane fighting wildfires crashed on the island of Evia, east of Athens, the Air Force said. It gave the ages 34 and 27. TV footage showed the plane dropping water over a fire and then crashing into a hillside and bursting into flames. State broadcaster ERT separately reported that the body of a 41-year-old stock breeder, who had been missing since Sunday, was found burned in a shack in a hard-to-reach area on Evia. Now, the general weather forecast for the country for today. Forecasting division says the weather is likely to be generally cloudy throughout the country. Light to moderate rain is likely to occur at a few places of hilly regions and at one or two places of the rest of the country. There are also chances of heavy rainfall with thunder and lightning at a few places of the Gandaki province, Lumbini province and Sudhura Pashim province. Kathmandu's weather report now. Maximum temperature of 26.7 degrees Celsius and minimum temperature of 21.2 degrees Celsius. With this news, we have come to the end of this bulletin. But before we wrap up the headlines once again. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachand addresses plenary session on food systems transformation on sidelines of UN Food Systems Summit in Italy. Prime Minister Dahal stresses the need for fighting battle against hunger and food insecurity. Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachand says that his government initiates a campaign to promote social justice and good governance. Dengue infection on the rise in the country. Over 4,000 people across the country infected with dengue fever. And China replaces Foreign Minister Qin Gang with Wang Yi. Well, that's all that we have for this edition. Our next English News edition is at 2 in the afternoon. You can also listen to us online at our website www.radionepal.gov.np for more news and online programs. Stay tuned, stay safe and have a good day.